Sports Chat 503. Welcome. 503. Today, Sports Chat, unofficially sponsored by the guy who paints his face at the basketball game. Thank you for having more spirit than us and showing everybody.
Yeah,
also, at what point does that guy's kid not want to paint his own face and, like, go against family rules?
Yeah, or maybe not even want to go to the game anymore because his dad's
embarrassing him.
Yeah. Ah, jeez. That'll happen, young.
Tough one.
Yeah.
Tough one. Okay, Sports Chat 503. Today we're talking about the NBA. NBA is cruising down. We're looking at, what do we call this, April or June or May madness.
Yeah.
It's kind of May madness.
Yeah, May madness.
It basically, the playoffs of NBA, I think, take 3 months. Mm-hmm. I think the playoffs are right around 3 months. And yeah. I think it's somewhere around 40 days. 40 days, they say, right? 40 days, 40 games, 40, something like that.
Yeah, they have some neat slogan. Yeah.
So that's like a month and a half, basically. Mm-hmm. So, what are we looking at here, bud? Who's coming out of the West? Who's coming out of the East?
Out of the West, I'm looking at, for the finals, it's going to be the Lakers, I think. Denver and LA, I think, are the two top teams. I don't think Dallas is going to get it. They dished Josh Howard, and I know he wasn't really producing a lot when they did. But, you know, I don't think Dallas has enough to compete with either of those teams. And out of the East, I like the Cavs and the Magic towards the... Or, I'm sorry. Do the Cavs and the Celtics.
Oh, yeah.
And because I think the Celtics will be able to pull together and work as a team. Magic just got Vince Carter this year. They haven't been through the fire with him yet. And Jameer Nelson's back, so don't know how he'll do at the end of a full season. So, and then out of those Cavs. So I'm going to say in the finals, Cavs, Lakers, and I hate the Lakers, but they're going to win the title again.
Oh, man. Okay. Yeah. So how about the Blazers? How do they do?
Blazers, I think...
One series? Will they even win a series?
You know, this is the nice thing, is that the Blazers, I don't really want them to move up to the seventh spot, because that means they would play...
Denver,
yeah. Crushed. And we got crushed a few weeks ago by Denver.
Yeah, they get crushed.
I think the best thing for the Blazers is to stay at eight.
You like the Lakers.
And play the Lakers, yeah. I know you've talked about this before.
They can beat them at home.
Yeah, and I guess that's the only real real concern.
They beat them once at Staples, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, I don't see the Blazers winning the opening rounds against the Lakers, unfortunately. What about you?
The Blazers. I think the Blazers have the best opportunity to beat, like, Phoenix.
Yeah.
I don't think they can beat Denver. I don't think they can beat the Lakers. I don't think they can beat Dallas.
Yeah.
I don't think they can beat those kind of teams. I think the teams they can beat are the teams like maybe a San Antonio.
Yeah.
Maybe like a, you know, Golden State, if Golden State were in it. You know, something like that. But Phoenix, I think they can slow Phoenix down.
Yeah.
Portland, I think, tries to be like the Boston of the West. And they're not really at all.
Yeah. They're one of the
slow down.
Yeah,
tempo.
They're like 28th or 29th in the league in fast break points.
Yeah, but they're also pretty high in field goal percentage, probably.
Yeah, and turnovers, they're not real bad at turnovers. So,
with a young team, I can see why they want to go with that.
Yeah, and you got like the teams like above Portland now. You got like San Antonio and Oklahoma City, Dallas, Denver, L.A. It's going to be tough for them to parlay that.
I think if Denver's going to win, it's this year.
Yep.
I think Carmelo is money. I've always thought he was a great player. I mean, who doesn't?
Yeah.
But I really think he's turned it on a notch right now. I think he's really got it flowing. Chauncey's obviously great. But I think the dynamic of what they have with Nene and Birdman And the difference between those two guys,
oh, yeah.
that balance, that can cause some chaos for LA.
Yeah.
I think LA is really pretty smooth. They got Bynum, who's big, but he's soft. Gasol, who's big, but he's soft. He looks like he gets pissed, but he's still pretty soft.
Yeah, he's hero.
Yeah, I mean, unless he has a horse and like a sword or something. Yeah. You know? But, you know, and I think that Lamar, although he's physically imposing, doesn't really, unless they're up by 10 or 12 points, really dominate a game, really impose his will.
Yeah.
I think Lamar kind of sits back and plays the little Rashid, you know, style of game.
Yeah.
Which is good basketball. That's you're a role player. You're not a dominant guy.
Yeah.
Know
your place.
Yeah, exactly. And be good at it.
Yeah.
But I think that if they can win, it's this year. Not saying that the Lakers aren't good. I think the Lakers are great. I think the Lakers are just as good this year as they were last year, and they could easily do what they did last year. But I think that the Nuggets have something this year rolling. And if J.R. Smith comes off the bench, it's just creating chaos. That's what I'm thinking the Nuggets can do.
Yeah.
That the Lakers, the Blazers, the Mavericks, anybody else in the West, they can't really do. They can't create that level of chaos, and I think Denver can do that.
What about out of the East then? Who's Denver going to be playing in this fictional championship game?
I've always thought LeBron is going to get his. I thought LeBron was going to win, 2004? Was it that long ago he was in the finals, that first time?
The first time?
That 2005, no, he was a rookie for.
Yeah, I think it was like 7.
Yeah, 007 or whatever, yeah. I don't know. The first time I thought LeBron could get the championship when he first went to the championship.
Against the Spurs, right?
Yeah, right. Yeah. And then I thought it was going to happen again. I thought it was going to happen last year. I thought it was going to happen. So I'm kind of to the point, it's kind of like Duke for me. I'm going to start rooting, not rooting against because I want to see LeBron win one, but I'm going to start kind of picking against those guys. Mm-hmm. And I think that the Magic have their number. They beat them last year. It's a different team this year, but the difference this year is Jameer Nelson's healthy. Playing the whole year. You don't have Rafer. Alston running the point anymore.
Yeah.
You know, Jameer is a much better point guard for that team. He gets Dwight Howard better looks at the basket, better offensive opportunity. And then you have Vince. And Vince is playing really well right now. And Vince is hungry. And Vince has never had deep experience except for that game 7. Remember, he took all that flack for, went to his graduation and then went to the thing on game 7. That's the closest he's got. So I think Vince could seriously look at this as a real opportunity to get to the finals.
Yeah.
And if they get to the finals against the Lakers or against the Nuggets, they might have an opportunity to win a couple games. I still think that the Nuggets or the Lakers still have an opportunity to win this thing, the whole thing.
Yeah. So,
I would love to see Nuggets and Orlando.
And Nuggets, Orlando.
Nuggets and Magic.
Wow, that would be good. And, you know, one of the things I had wrong with...
be more fun.
Yeah, it would. Dwight Howard in the finals against Kobe.
But Jameer, I think, is really active.
I mean, Denver, my man.
I think Jameer's really active. Yeah. And I think that team really plays off his activity.
Yeah, I was going
to
say...
Kind of like Damon used to play with the Blazers.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I remember I was going to say that... you know, they don't have Turkoglu, so, and Vince doesn't run the ball at the point very well.
It's not that backdoor cut, the pick and roll stuff.
But, you know, the thing is that this year, like you were saying, they'll have Jameer.
Right.
So they wouldn't really need a Turkoglu type to run the point for the playoffs because they'll have their regular point guard to run the top. So, who the hell am I picking again?
The whole thing. Who do you think
the whole thing? Yeah, the whole thing. Unfortunately, Lakers. I don't like them, but they're going to win. Phil Jackson. Is this going to be number 10 or 11?
11 or
Phil?
12.
12? What about you? You got...
I'm thinking, you know what? Let's go Carmelo. Let's roll the dice. Ah! Nuggets.
Yeah?
Create some chaos, Nuggets.
Yeah.
J.R. Smith off the bench, scoring about 20. Yeah. Carmelo to the lane gets 30 every night with ease. Nene crashes boards.
Yeah.
Birdman with swats.
Kenyon
Martin with some nice physicality in the lane.
Yeah, and Chauncey too. I mean,
forget, man. He's the guy hitting free throws down the stretch.
Yeah,
hitting big threes.
He's got experience. He's
bigger than Fish.
Yeah.
I'm digging. I'm going with it. I'm going with
good,
it.
Man.
Why not?
Nuggets.
Okay. And who do you got winning the whole thing?
Lakers. Nuggets.
Sports Chat, 503, baby. Thank you for representing. Check out any other videos over there as well, YouTube members.
On that side.
Or this side, or whatever. Sports Chat, adios.
Peace.